Okay, so some of you asked for me to show you how you do Newman projections. So we'll make a little video here, but this is butane, right? So that has four carbons in it. So it's, carbon one is over here on mine. One, two, three, four. And then I label them so that you can see carbon one, right? And if I turn this like this, you can see carbon two and carbon three. I'll rotate as carbon four. So I have an orientation of the molecule. And then what I'm going to do is I am going to turn it. And then on the screen, what you'll see up in the corner is I'll show you the Newman projection for the different ways we're viewing this. So I want to look at this usually between C2 and C3. So I'm going to turn C2 towards the camera because there's a direction to this, C2, C3, right? If I said C3 to C2, then I'd be looking at C3. And then C2, you notice how it goes in the back, you can't see it. So this is what we're dealing with when we're dealing with the Newman projection. This is butane. And I'm gonna look down C2, C3. So I'm gonna turn that towards the camera, like that. And now I have C1 straight up in the front. That's carbon number one. And I'm gonna make this eclipse. So, you know, if I go exactly centered like that and I make this exactly eclipsed, you can't see anything in the back. So what we do is we try to tilt it a little bit like this. So you're gonna see a Newman projection. You'll see the hydrogens together here and here. The hydrogens here and here. And then the methyl groups are here and here. This is the highest steric interaction conformer for butane, because if you turn this sideways, you can see they're like overlapping on each other. They actually touch. Okay. This is a very high energy, and this molecule is free to rotate. Remember, single bonds are free to rotate. So the natural inclination is for that large group that's on C1 to move far away from the large group that's C4. So when I do that, we're going to show this Newman projection. I turn it this way so you can see C2. Oh, by the way, we're in a lab, so if you hear a lot of noise, that's what that is. Looks like that. So I'll draw that Newman projection on the screen, and I'll post that up so you can see it. Okay. Again, this is a staggered conformer, right? Because what we're doing is we're looking at these as every other. So there's a hydrogens in the front, and then the back between is the methyl, which is actually C4. Now you're not seeing C3. I'd have to turn it like that for you to see C3. Right? And then there's the hydrogen in the front on this side. Right? So there are unique conformers in butane. One of them is gauche. So if I put gauche on the screen, oops, sorry, I gotta get camera orientation. Camera, this is also a staggered conformer, but now there's a little bit more space between the methyl groups because they're a little bit further apart. So that's a little bit lower in energy. So in reality, this molecule is going to rotate like this. Okay. And these groups can be far apart or close to each other. And this is the highest energy. The next highest energy is that one where this group here, right, is close to this hydrogen here. Now, if you look at what that is, that's actually this. That's an eclipsed conformer. And then what you have is this group interacting here, right? And then also on the other side, you have these groups interacting here. Okay, so hopefully that helps. And I'll, like I said, I'll draw these different conformers up for you on the screen, and then you can compare them. Thank you.